and welcome back to the Disney Nerds Podcast. I'm Sam, and I'm here in Batu on Galaxy's Edge, and I'm with Nathaniel. Nathaniel was the Walt Disney World Ambassador in 2015 and 16. How are you, sir?
Bright suns. I'm doing great. And yourself?
Bright suns to you as well. Straight into character, which is what I absolutely expect here in Galaxy's Edge. Tell me a little bit about your impressions of what's happening here.
I absolutely love it, Sam. I just hear your excitement, and that's the same excitement that I see day in and day out through every single guest that walks into Galaxy's Edge right here at Disney's Hollywood Studios.
I mean, look behind us. It's the Millennium Falcon, full size, the first time ever. This is amazing.
Yes. What I love about the Star Wars franchise is it is multi-generational, right? I remember, you know, there's parents that have seen it with their parents and now seen it with their kids, and now we have families who grandparents bring their kids and then grandkids to all experience it together, right? And the Millennium Falcon is a staple of the brand. And not only this attraction gets to show you the Millennium Falcon, but it gets to ride it, and you get to play a very active part into the attraction.
Absolutely, and that's the Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run. Mm-hmm. Rise of the Resistance is opening. That's why we're here. That's another amazing attraction.
It is the largest attraction that we have ever had in any of our Disney parks, and it's going to be even more immersive, right? Because you get to literally not be part of the story, but you get to be in the story. So everything happens around you. You are playing with different dimensions. The Imagineers have really pulled every tool of the toolbox to make sure that this is amazing. And there's character inclusions also in the attraction, which we've never done before. Kylo Ren is on it. You know, the Stormtroopers, Rey. So we really want to make sure that you join the Resistance to fight the First Order.
Absolutely. It's amazing. And as I look around the land, the marketplace, Doc Ondor's, the cantina, I can go right down the list. But one of the things you were talking about a few minutes ago is the backstory of the cast members here.
Yeah.
So if we can maybe step back a little bit, maybe a little behind the scenes.
Yeah.
What goes into making this what it is?
First of all, I see that you're a frequent citizen. You know quite well about the planet of Batu. But so to your point, we have citizens, right? So the citizens are the ones that bring the cast members that bring Batu to life in Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. And you know, our cast members are so passionate about the saga. They're so passionate about the brand, passionate about the guest experience, that every single cast member that comes here as part of the onboarding have a backstory, right? The story of Batu is that we are in a rebel spy base, right? And some cast members are citizens of Batu. Some cast members are part of the rebels. The rebels. Some of them are spies. Some of them are First Order. So what I challenge every guest is to talk to the cast members in the stores, in the marketplace, at the cantina, the attraction, and ask them, what is their story, right? What side are they in? They might not tell you the full truth because they don't know if you are the spy or, you know, part of the First Order, but they'll all have a different story, and they'll tell you exactly where they came to be.
So the challenge for cast members here is to create your own backstory that fits into the Star Wars universe. I think that's fascinating.
It is fascinating, and I absolutely love it because, in every other land, they all kind of share the same story, right? Whether you're in a Fantasy and the Magic Kingdom, it's one story. If you're over at Pandora, it's the same story. But here, everyone is going to come from a different planet. They'll have a different story how it came to be. Some of them might be locals, right? And they're just here trying to make a living. So you never know what story they're going to tell you.
And it makes me wonder, Nathaniel, is there a First Order marker underneath your name tag here?
I mean, I have to say, I'm very impartial, you know, to either side, but I do love the dark side.
Or you're a smuggler. I'm not sure, because that's an affiliation, right?
Although you never know, right? So, Mr. Story, but like, you know, right now we're going to play nice. I'm here with the Millennium Falcon, so I don't want Chewbacca, you know, or Rey to come on me. But I do have a soft spot for Kylo Ren and Darth Vader, so the darker side is always a good place to be for me.
I get it. And that's some of that backstory, what's happening here. It's absolutely fascinating. Rise of the Resistance opening soon. The land is in full operation. Can I say that?
It is a full operation. It's starting December 5th completely, right? The Rise of the Resistance is the last part that we were missing to it. It's finally here, and we can't wait to see all of our guests into this wonderful attraction.
Yep, and we see the guests around us now. Thank you for your time, Nathaniel.
Of course. Thank you, Sam, and may the Force be with you.
Well, thank you very much, and thank you guys for watching the Disney Nerd Podcast. Much more coming from Batu, from Galaxy's Edge, from food and beverage merchandise, you name it. There's so much happening. You need to get here to this planet. Kongaloosh.